So I'm Nick Jury, and we're in the Laboratory of Behavioral and Genomic Neuroscience, Andrew Holmes Lab at National Institute for Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism. So I study the brain in alcohol abuse, but specifically between males and females. So I grew up in the Midwest. I'm from Illinois, proud Illini. I think what really got me interested in science and in exploring research was my grandfather. My grandfather was always tinkering around in the basement with either some electronic piece or woodworking. I think the defining moment for me was I was working in an undergrad lab, and we were working on this really complex issue problem, and we got the answer we were looking for, and my advisor at the time, we kind of high-fived each other, and that was kind of the aha moment, that it's like, oh, okay, I think I could see myself doing this for the remainder of my career, yeah. On a day-to-day basis, I have male and female subjects that receive chronic exposure to alcohol, and I then look at their brains for different markers, different things that may tell us about their behavior or about their propensity to become addicted. So I've got two different slices that I've taken from the brain. What I'm looking at is I'm looking at the little projections off of the dendrite, and these are called spines. And what we're looking for is either the presence or absence of these dendrites, the structure. We're looking for either a disruption of the structure. So this is normal. And as you can see, as we look at the gene knocked out, this dendrite has some abnormalities in it based on the genotype. So I use a microscope to look at the brain and look at different changes that we might see in the brain to determine what the alcohol is doing to the brain. Right in there. The wild type animals, the normal animals, are responding differently than the animals with the gene knocked out because of the alcohol. So the alcohol is having a much more of a worse impact on this neuron versus the normal animal. And this is relevant to look at this because this gene is thought to be involved in decision making in different parts of the brain. And you know, we all make decisions whether we're gonna abuse alcohol. This could be very relevant in the human condition. It's always, what's the next question? Where is it going? And sometimes it's hard to decide because there's so many different directions it can go in. But that's exciting. That's what science is. You answer the question and then it's like a fork in the road. You go left, you go right. Where does it lead? And it's just a constant multiplication of that. The fact that we're involved in research that may potentially lead to treatment or cures is just, it's just amazing. You get the result from the experiment and it kind of leads you into several different directions, and I'm constantly talking with everyone in the lab, you know, sharing data.
I'm really excited about that operant extinction data that I showed you. So it really looks like the alcohol is having an effect. I'm really, really interested to see what that's going to show.
There's a lot of work to be done, but it's always nice to be able to share in the results with other people. Figure out what you're interested in and volunteer. We get to do things that not that everyone gets to do every day. We get to answer questions that are hopefully clinically relevant to the human condition, and not everyone can say that every day.